I love art, but I have no talent when it comes to art. So my way of doing art was to needlepoint.
We have a lot of people that do just try to make their own things, and we encourage that because we have the supplies for it.
You don't find too many places that carry this kind of artwork, and it's really, I think, it's an important thing to have out there because there's so much culture in needlepoint.
But there aren't many of these places left. They're always very helpful. They have everything you need. They're efficient.
My wife, Joan, wanted to go into the needlepoint business. And I said, you want to open up this store as your needlepoint shop? So she says to me, are you kidding? I says, no. I says, you want to open up the shop? Basically, that's where we start. And
we have a lot of customers with dogs. We have customers that their dog won't let them pass by the store without stopping in.
Joan always insisted that the people get service when they come in and treat the customers with respect. That was the credo that she established, whether the person bought something for $2 or whether they bought something for $200. We sell hand-painted needlepoint canvases. We sell needlepoint kits, which are not hand-painted, they're stamped. And they come with the threads in a package. Also, we have cross-stitch, counted cross-stitch and stamped cross-stitch. We have patterns that people can buy to see what project they want to work on. It's a cross-stitch, they tell them what colors they need for the threads. And we also have counted cross-stitch kits. And we also had latch hook kits and crewel kits. Those two things we were exclusive in a city. We provided a pillow service where people would bring in the finished needlepoint to have made into a pillow. For a while, we provided a framing service if people want their needlepoint framed. We had an ad in the New York Telephone Yellow Pages for 25 years. Also, word of mouth was very big advertising for us because people would hear about us from their friends. One day I got a call from a magazine in Japan and said that they heard about our shop, so they came down and took some pictures. About 6 or 8 months later, we had a couple people from Japan come in and they showed us the picture in the magazine. The New York Times, they were doing an article on pillows that were made from needlepoint. And then Joan got a call, and the woman said, do you mind if we make you the subject of the article? So they sent a photographer down. They took the picture of Joan with the finished pillows, and it appeared in the New York Times, and our pillow business increased in the next couple of years. There was another time when one of our customers, she said that she worked for the Daily News and writes a column about purchasing stores, so she wanted to know if we would mind being in the column, and she sent a photographer down, and that picture appeared in the paper. Just, the picture was just a couple customers going through canvases. People came in because of that article. That kind of publicity is worth a lot to bring people in. We have customers that have been coming here for years and years and years. They're not happy about it.
Well, a good deal of them are quite sad about it. Yeah, we've had, next to nearly begging on the ground to stay open. But
I never went to another needlepoint place but this one. I feel so bad this place is closing because I can't really find a place that it's equivalent to what I had here.
That's a great store. I'm surprised it's closing. It's going to be a big loss for this kind of hobby.
I really feel bad they really are closing. They were wonderful people, and I wish that this place would just stay open.
I tell them, because of the economy, it pushes me towards retirement. Joan expressed her desire to, she hoped she could stay in business for at least 25 years. And unfortunately, Joan passed away in January of 97. but this is our 26th year in business, so we fulfilled her wish.